magazine, thanks for showing up again. This time I've got my daughter-in-law, Samantha.
Hello.
I'm at her place. I've been recovering from surgery the last couple weeks, and they've been gracious enough to take care of me through that a great deal, so that's been awesome. Before that, just before my surgery, just days before that, we went to Costa Rica, her hometown, and it was absolutely beautiful. So I thought it would be cool to do a video on her interests and some music that we picked up down there at a music store called Vertigo in a mall.
Mm-hmm.
And this is her lovely...
my little baby. Ruby.
Show
your hat. Show your Costa
Rica
hat.
The thing about this hat is, one of the cool things is that it's actually not a giant trucker hat. And so, yeah, I've been wearing it a lot. I meant to wear a different one yesterday, but I had to come back with the souvenir and so. What I've got here is a Costa Rican Coca-Cola. As you can see, I'm in Costa Rica at the moment. And this is Ultimate Edition Limited Sin Azucar. I don't know how you say it. Sin, meaning no sugar. Interesting word there, sin, for no. Creations, looks like a Coke logo. It's a League of Legends video game edition, apparently. I just thought this, zero calories, you know? I mean, it's still Coca-Cola, but I just thought this was really cool looking can, appropriate for this area here. And this is off the cuff, so we'll see how different this Coke tastes here, this version of a Costa Rican Coca-Cola with no sugar, which is a little ironic since there's sugar everywhere down here. It should say with Costa Rica, pure cane Costa Rican sugar. It tastes like a Diet Coke, a sugar-free Coke. Best part is it's cold. Very fitting with this beautiful 80-something, like 85 degrees or something, and awesome. It's perfect for me when it's like 0 degrees at home. So, one last sip. Yeah, it tastes like Coke. But it's got a really cool can. Anyway, one of the things that happened when I was down there is her mother gave me some records that she had, and so I thought I'd show those real fast. The first one of note that was of interest to me, one I don't have, is this Doors album. And this is gonna have to come off. This is all tattered and torn, and it doesn't show up in the video very well anyway.
Okay.
This is a second pressing, so it's a repress, I think 79. And a lot of these ended up getting some. Once again, some of them have, they all had shrink on them, but the shrink is destroyed. And
yeah,
so
the humidity.
But yeah, a lot of these have some light and humidity effects on the edges of these.
Mm-hmm.
And
was that there from Costa Rica?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
And this one, I grabbed because I believe this is one that was going to use for a certain video I'm going to do in the future. And so, like, this sleeve is a little warped and stuff, and they all have a dish warp on them. And so I would suggest, more than likely, if you live in Costa Rica, you probably know to keep them in. I put most of my valuable records in a resealable sleeve. And so I would suggest that. Now, one of the questions that I was going to have was, first question is, does anybody have a fireplace in Costa Rica?
No. Because it's too hot.
Weather was perfect to me in the 80s all the time, and I don't know if people get, you're either used to it, or do you ever get tired of the heat?
Oh, I did, but most people are used to it. I didn't like the heat, though.
Yeah.
So when I got introduced to the AC here, it was awesome.
Yeah. But we stayed at your brother's place, and there was AC there,
yeah.
And it was very comfortable. And to me, I was comfortable wherever I was at in there, because a lot of times there's a breeze.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, and so that was awesome. What about humidifiers?
No, definitely not.
No humidifier? Dehumidifiers, what do you mean?
Oh, dehumidifiers. Yeah, I'm sure they use them, but I don't remember seeing anything like that.
Yeah. Because I think I saw somebody showed in a store, that was one of the things he noted, is you can buy dehumidifiers. And so as far as records go, that might would be something that would help.
Yeah.
So you grew up there.
Yes.
And what's the kind of music that you grew up with? I assume that's maybe why mm-hmm. this would be here.
Mm-hmm. Well, I grew up with all kinds of different music. Like, my dad had a lot of influence, so he showed me the classic rock. He showed me all those bands, like, not just classic rock, also Madonna, Celine Dion, things like that, random people. But then my mom showed me more of the Spanish music, and then I had a lot of influence from TV and watching TV music videos growing up. And so I had most of the music that we got in Costa Rica. We don't have a lot of local bands. We have a couple that are good, but mostly we got bands from Spain or Argentina or other countries. So we didn't have a lot of local bands. So
what would have been your favorite stuff?
What was my favorite band? My favorite music?
Yeah.
Well, you do have a record of them. I did love Héroes del Silencio, that's what they're called. They're from Spain. I love them, and we would listen to them constantly on the radio. They were playing. They're still playing today. Like, they play them all the time. And Ricardo Arjona, you have that on one of the records too. But one of my favorite music was I do love metal too. I love metal, and I was a big fan of Slayer for a while. But then I kind of switched a little bit to a little bit more positive lyrics, but I do love metal. So, yeah.
Well, some of that, your dad was from America pretty much.
Yes.
But he lived there a very long time.
Yes.
Yeah. And, but these are some of his mm-hmm. 7 inches.
Yes.
It's kind of cool when there's sleeves, when you actually have the sleeves. And a lot of this is pop music from those days or so.
Yeah.
Quite a few. Tell us about this one.
Well, so Massey Ferguson, so he had a company, he had a tractor company. So this is, I guess we found it, and it was just a story of that company. I didn't really understand it because I wasn't here. It was when I was a baby, but he had a tractor company, and so... So this is just
it's a really cool promo. Yeah. And unfortunately, we don't know where the sleeve is for this, because it's a really cool looking sleeve for, you know, back in the day. And the music is Here Comes Massey is a song. It sounds like it was written in the 40s. So that's really neat to find.
Mm-hmm.
So you mentioned that you're a Slayer fan.
Yes.
And I played a little bit of Living Sacrifice for you.
Yes.
I'm gonna hand you some of these so you can show the. You can show the record and then hand it back to me. Just pull that out and show. So I played her some Living Sacrifice. She wasn't completely familiar with it. This is not the debut, but these are some records I recently got. And
you want it back in there?
Yeah, you can just put it back in there.
Okay.
This is the Reborn album. It's on a nice cover stock. This is where they got kind of mathy, kind of like prong. And so those are the days, the early 90s, where people were getting real mathy, the math rock. I played you a song off of this album.
Mm-hmm. Really good.
And what did you think of this?
I think it reminded me of how much I love metal and why and how where it started. I would go to concerts growing up in Costa Rica, and we would just watch bands play for hours and hours and hours. And so I just sitting here listening to it, it was really, really good. It was called Bloodwork. Is that what it was called?
Yeah, I think that song was
one of the songs Bloodwork. Yeah, one of the songs that we listened to. But so that was. I loved it. I mean, I don't know if I'm great at conveying why I love it, but I just enjoyed so much listening to every instrument and watching. I used to even watch on TV, where I would play DVDs of concerts. I would watch them by myself. Loved it.
The live shows, the thrill of the live show.
Yes. So this is a really good band. I definitely will be listening to it more.
I believe this is where Rocky Gray from Evanescence came in, I think, on this album, and he's been with them since then.
Hmm.
This is where the Meshuga djent influence came in, and so there's a lot of percussion. Reminded me of Soulfly, which when we were traveling down there, mm-hmm. is trying to find the right Soulfly song to play. And we didn't find the right Soulfly song to play down there. This is the latest one of theirs I got, and cool. Shows the whole dudes. These guys are from Arkansas, and they've always been cool. I like to call them friends. They would recognize me if they saw me. Because we've been around together for so long.
It's a, really
it's a
cool
double
record.
Album with this. Yeah, really. It actually looks like real Hot
That's
Rod
really
Flames.
Cool.
And this one, this has more pronounced percussion. Matthew Putnam from Love Drug. When I first saw them setting up percussion, I was like, you know, like Cornerstone Fest or a show in Kansas City or something. I thought, oh, two drummers. This might be loud, you know. But no, it just added just the extra percussion. It sounded cool. This album is a little bit more like Testament's Low, so a little more of the metal thing. I think there might be an etching on the other side. Let's see real fast. Yeah, there's actually the Living Sacrifice logo etched etched into the crown. Crown of Thorns. If you can see that at all, there's probably a lot of glare. So anyway, cool. I put this away and we didn't talk about it. But you got to where you found this band, and how did you come across August Burns Red? This is not August Burns Red.
That's Led Zeppelin. August Burns Red's right here.
Oh, I hear it.
So we went to Furnace Fest with you, actually, and David, my husband, and we saw them live, and completely fell in love with them. And I love that it's angry music for happy people. That's their like slogan thing they say. We're about to go see them also on February 25th as well, but that's where we got introduced.
You're going to go to Florida to go see August Burns Red?
Yes, we're going. We love them that much. And they have good lyrics. I think that's important to me with music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, very cool. They're kind of, they've got, if I remember correctly, it's the post-hardcore with the melodies, you know, screaming it, and then
mm-hmm.
both kinds of vocals.
Yes.
And stuff. Very cool.
Mm-hmm.
So, Costa Rican music. This is not Costa Rican, but so people in Costa Rica love.
Yes, it's something that most people would know. Well, I guess from my age would know.
Yeah.
And my parents, and we would just listen to them all the time on the radio. And they still play them today. So, yeah, most people would know.
Yeah.
Héroes del Silencio. Heroes of Silence, basically, that's what they're called.
Yeah.
So.
This, as you might be able to tell, this is in the days of the alarm and the cult. This reminds me a lot of the cult, which actually kind of has the Doors influence. The cult kind of are influenced by the Doors, and this has that song, that sound, the cult song, but leans a little more towards the alarm and U2 arena. So more, it's one of those things that the whole thousands of people are going to be singing along and stuff,
mm-hmm.
and to this arena rock, and it's got some metal elements in it.
Yeah.
And this is actually produced by Phil Manzanera, which I just picked up three of his albums this year. Some real cool jazz that's got a little bit of Latin flavor, maybe. But yeah, they've got that style. I was telling somebody the other day, I've got a picture of me and David's mom wearing these kinds of outfits, and I really wish I could. I would really wish I could find those picture, because they probably got thrown away, and nobody should see these pictures. But I think it would be cool. let's see which one I'm doing. I think I want to do this one first.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us about this.
So Ricardo Arjona, he I believe he's also from Spain. I'm pretty sure he is. But he was very popular growing up. I actually would listen and sing to his songs with one of my best friends as little kids. We would just sing them all the time. But he's just more, he always sings about love, and women love him. So a lot, I mean, men too, but you know, mostly a lot of women love him.
Yeah, I saw videos and guys were crying in the eye.
Yeah, he's just a very well-known artist. He's incredible, an incredible singer, and his voice is just so different. So mm-hmm. When you listen to him, he just sounds very different than most singers. And so very popular in Costa Rica still to this day. You listen to the radio and they'll play his songs a lot.
Yeah.
So
He looks like Antonio Banderas. Yeah. There.
Yeah, he does.
Some of his videos, he doesn't. He looks more like he's having fun at the beach. There's one song on here,
which one?
The second, I think it's
Cavernicolas.
Cavernicolas. I'm working on me and Duolingo are getting,
are getting a
close relationship lately. So I'm in beginning stages again. I'm trying to learn my Spanish again. Anyway, that song Cavernicolas has some great melody. That check that song out, you'll be singing along like everyone else does to this
oh, great.
To this album. Yeah, it's more on the, there's a lot of fun here and a lot of romance here. And so.
So you like Ricardo Arjona then?
That was a great album. I liked all three of these. And this, in some ways, a little bit, maybe my favorite, but this record cover really grabbed me. I was really disappointed that this is not on vinyl, because this is such a cool,
a cool
cover. And but we ordered it and we thought it said CDR, and we thought, what kind of disc is that going to be? You know, just in a white folder. But no, I love digipacks, and this is a great digipack.
And this is a Costa Rican band.
Yeah, so tell us about this a little bit.
So maltipoo is one of the only bands that I knew that were from Costa Rica that are not like reggaeton or something that's not, has no substance. So they definitely do. I mean, they're, if I can go through every of these lyrics, there's stories in it. He's very poetic with his lyrics, and it's beautiful music. I mean, wonderful. I don't even know what genre that would be. This, you know? To me, it's just, I can listen to them. It is more like, I feel like it's more peaceful for me, but he is so full of like passion and love when he sings. Like there's one story, I'll just talk about one. So there's one of the stories on here, I'm trying to remember which one it was, but there's one of the songs that he has where he's talking about a Nicaraguan and a Costa Rican that are in love, and because there's discrimination between both countries, people do not accept their relationship. So it's like about that love that they have, that's impossible love. And so he's, I don't know if it's on here, but it's a beautiful song. And it's very, it makes me cry every time I listen to it, so.
Yes, it's a multi-instrumental band. There's once again, a lot of percussion and violins and flutes. It's all kinds of flavor to this. One song, where is it? Son.
Which one?
I think it's this one.
Son Inu.
Sonino.
I don't really know.
It reminds me a lot of it reminds me of Santana. It's got, if that's the right one, maybe it's the next song. What's the song after that? Is it
Zapateo?
Yeah, I can't remember which one it is. I think it's the song.
Son Inu.
Either that's the one that has a melody on it. Real rich melody, and the Zappy-Doo is the one that's Santana, but I think it's the sun. That sounds a lot. Anyway, the song on there, it's got a lot of, it reminds me of Santana with some blazing guitar on there. So there's a lot of a variety, but it you know, it all comes together. And so Malpais.
Mm-hmm. And Malpais is also a place in Costa Rica too. Is right next to where we went to the beach. There's an actual place called Malpais. It's a beautiful beach, and right next to it is Santa Teresa, which if you ever go to Costa Rica, that's a great place to go. It just takes a while to get there.
Yeah.
But it's beautiful. It literally translates to bad country for some reason. That's what they picked, Malpais, but it's actually gorgeous there. So.
Yeah. Santa Teresa.
Santa Teresa.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that was an awesome beach. I wish I had got more surfing. I didn't get any surfing videos, I don't think. But we were kind of, you could watch them from where the beach that we were at. But it was an awesome place to go. I didn't wake up to roosters. I woke up to monkeys waking me up in the morning with the breeze blowing through the windows. That was pretty amazing. Mm-hmm. So anyway, it was an awesome time. I was really, really glad that I went, I hesitated because of my surgery. I was like, I'm going to go down there. I need surgery next week. And, but I was really, really, really glad, grateful I was for that trip. That was amazing. It was.
Well, it's not the last one. Yeah. We still need to go back to see the volcano and the monkeys.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what do they say in Costa Rica?
What's the saying? We say pura vida. It means pure life. The actual translation, but pura vida just means like when people say hi, they say pura vida. It's all good. Is everything good? And it's just kind of like a saying that everybody just says. Like, how are you? Pura vida.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing.
So, anything else?
No. I had fun. Ruby and I had fun sharing today. Yep. Right? She wants to go and bark at things. We're keeping her.
So, yeah, it's I saw that a lot, and you can see why when you're down there, and it's related to what I usually always end my videos with. Right on. Right on.
But wait! There's more!
Now, of course, we didn't go to Costa Rica to look for records. However, on Samantha's birthday, she actually took us to look at a damaged freight store where it didn't find any music. And I didn't think these inner sleeves were really worth picking up. As far as buying new records, they're pretty pricey, at least at the Vertigo store in the mall near the airport. The two I did take home were about 52 colon each, which is doubled in dollars to over $100 each. If you can imagine that. This Alan Parsons project is at 95 cologne. That's about $200. So 30% off of $200 for that. The new Beatles, Red. 71, so double that. Yeah, that's the kind of record players they have. The Sepultura would have liked to taken that home from there, but not at $80. Didn't think that was worth it. They had quite a variety of new stuff. You know, I mean, if you got the money to pay for that. It's kind of a neat store. And I did have a record waiting for me in the snow when I got home. Now, my trip to Costa Rica was absolutely amazing. And I hope you get a chance to check it out sometime also. Looks to me like also a great place to live. I love the temperatures down there. Now, as I always say, go out there and use what God blessed you with to do something cool for someone else. This is Steve with Salt Magazine. Thanks for stopping by.